I will give you a walk through all the fields on the location card in Business Central. So the locations are the geographical places where we store our inventory, and you can define as many locations as you want to, of course, and I'll just show you the fields in the location card. First of all, the code, which is the unique key for the location and the name. And then there's a checkmark called use as in transit. This checkmark is meant if you use this location for transfer orders, meaning when you ship the transfer order from one location, it has to be held somewhere in the system until you receive it in the other location. So a transit location is like a buffer location where you store your items. Then you have the address on your location, which is all self-explaining. And the contact could be a primary contact in charge of that specific location that you want to enter here. In the warehouse tab, there's a lot of different selections. One of them is the directed put away and pick. And if you checkmark this one, all the other one will be checkmarked by default, so you can't change them. This means you are using a full warehouse and thereby are locked into using all the other functionality. So I'll just take another location to continue this small demo so you can see whatever they are doing. Let's take my simple warehouse here. Here we didn't checkmark the put away and pick field, meaning we can select between all the other selections here. If we require to receive the goods, meaning do we require to make a received document, and do we require to make a shipment document on the outbound side? Likewise, do we require to make a put away and a put away document, meaning after receiving it on the ramp, do we need to have or do we would like to use a document for putting it away to hand it to the warehouse guy so we can go around in the inventory to put it away? And is it mandatory for us to use a put away worksheet, meaning that the put away document is not automatically created while posting the receipt, but is created in a worksheet? You can checkmark this one. And of course, you can only checkmark that if you checkmark the fields above and the require receipt field, because those relate to those two, of course. Then require pick, meaning do you require on the outbound side to create pick documents for picking the items before shipping it on the shipment. The bin mandatory fields mean that you will have to enter bin codes every time you handle the item. And this is basically the field you use if you want to control items per bin. So you have one item stored in many places in your warehouse. The ADCS, the automatic data capture system, is meant for automatically data capture and comes out of the box from Business Central. And in the market, you can find many other solutions for capturing data with different scanner devices. Default bin selection is stating whether you want a fixed bin to be the default bin or you want to use the last use bin to set up as the bin suggested by the system. Outbound and inbound warehouse handling time is about the time calculated on the inbound and the outbound document, meaning if you are making, for instance, a purchase order with an expected receipt date on a certain date, and your inbound warehouse handling time here is, for instance, 2 days, you enter like a date formula, the planned receipt date would be 2 days before, meaning we will expect the warehouse to use 2 days to handle the item before it's actually available in stock. So this is a time buffer to make a slot for the warehouse people to get the item in stock or out of stock. The base calendar code you can select for using in the warehouse is if you want to calculate with days availability in the warehouse, and if the customized calendar applies to your base calendar code if you want to make deviation, saying that on specific date we're not working because of whatever, you can checkmark those in here. The use cross-docking field can be selected if you are using both shipment and putaways. You can choose to cross-dock the item, meaning instead of putting it into your warehouse, you can calculate that item should be taken directly from your inbound ramp and put to your outbound ramp, so you don't have to handle it in the warehouse, but can select it directly. And if you use the cross-dock do calculation formula here, it's about telling for how long time we want to look when we are checking for cross-docking items. On the bin tab, there's a lot of bin fields you can enter if you have checkmarks the bin mandatory selection up here. And those fields would be what is your receipt bin code, meaning when you post the receipt on the inbound side, there's a bin code for where the receipt should go to the bin. Likewise, on the outbound side, what is your shipment bin code? In the production area, there's an open shop floor bin code. There's a general shop floor bin where you can put the item. And then there's a consumption bin, the to production bin code, meaning if you pick from the warehouse for the production people to consume it, there's a default bin code here where you can place the item. Likewise, when the production is done and they output the item, they will put it on the from production bin code where the warehouse people can pick it. And it's the same on the assembly side, the to assembly bin code, from assembly bin code, and the assembly to order shipment bin code is on the sales order, where you can, if you use assembly to order, you have to have somewhere to pick your assembly item into a bin that the order can pick it from. Cross-dock bin code is if you're using cross-docking, of course, and the adjustment bin code is if you do inventory adjustment, there has to be a bin code for positive and negative warehouse adjustment. The bin policies apply to the checkmark with directed put away and pick, so we'll go back to the advanced location in here and roll down. And the bin policy could be if you like the special equipment code, if you're using that to accord to your bin or to come from your item. Your bin capacity policy, meaning do you want to use a maximum capacity on a bin and would you like to allow or prohibit to exceed that capacity on a different bin? Would you allow break bulk, meaning would you allow to split from one unit of measure code to another unit of measure code in the warehouse? So if somebody wants to pick pieces but we only store in boxes, do we allow the system to break a box for us? Put away template code is used if you are using putaways, of course, and you can define if you always want to create putaway lines, meaning even though there's nothing to put away, should it create a line or not? And likewise on the pick side, would you like always to create pick lines, meaning should it create a pick line even though the item is not available in stock? And you might want to use that, for instance, if you expect the item to get on stock when you create the pick documents, and then the line should be there, of course. Normally, we would suggest not to set this checkmark. And the last field, pick according to FIFO, meaning first expired, first out. If you have items using expiration date, should the pick be designed to take the oldest one first, or the one who expires first? So this is the fields on the location card.